for this day that he has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Amen. And we're just going to go forth in prayer. We ask that you would join us in our worship, that you would lift your hands, that you would indeed invite God where you are. He wants to be near you. So we ask that even now, if you would stand and begin to worshiping and praising your God as we begin to go to his throne. Amen. Amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we thank you and we praise you, God, for you alone are God, and besides you there is none other. You indeed are the Alpha and the Omega. You are the beginning and the end, Lord. And we bless your name. We come into this house, Lord. We gather in your name to give you worship, to give you glory, to give you honor, to give you praise, Lord God. We come, Father God, bowing in your presence, Lord. We come to acknowledge that you indeed are a good God and your mercy endures forever. Father, we ask in the name of Jesus Christ that you will remember every mother today, God. Father, whether they're mothers, God, naturally, Father, or if they're mothers because, God, their siblings have children, or if they're mothers, God, just by mentoring, God, remind them today of the importance of the roles that they're playing in the lives of your people. Father, let them know that you hear them, that you're with them. And Father, be with those, God, that may not have their mothers this morning, God. Draw nigh to them in the name of Jesus Christ. Comfort them like never before. Father God, we ask today, God, that you will come into this house, Lord God, and that you will enter into every house of the people that are watching. Father, we want to have an encounter today with your person so that we can have an encounter today with your power, God. In the name of Jesus, be glorified. We love you, Lord. And we ask that you would have your way today in Jesus' name. Now put your hands together.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Do you believe he is an on-time God? Hallelujah.
Amen. I'm glad he's an on-time God. How about y'all? I'm a witness that he's
Hallelujah.
An on-time God. If I could get just a little bit of volume here, that would be great. Come on and clap those hands. Need a little bit of volume, little bit of volume. Thank you, Trey. Y'all glad to be here today?
Yeah.
Man.
Joseph said he may not come when you want him, but he'll be
Good morning. I'm up here to do several announcements. The first announcement this morning is the one about our Founders Day for Come As You Are. Amen. Yeah. And that will be, our special guest is going to be Bishop W.L. Bolton. He's the founding pastor of Come As You Are Community Church. And that theme will be, he will finish what he started. And it will be June the 5th of 2022. And there will be a light meal, a fellowship meal, served after worship service. Amen? So put that down on your calendar. And then the next announcement. God, I got all these papers. The next announcement is May. As we all know, that May is recognized as Mental Health Month. And so Come As You Are has co-partnered with Health Visions. Everybody know who Health Visions is. Sharon Tubbs is in the what is she, the president or something of Health Visions. But anyway, we have partnered with them or co-partnered with them, and we will be doing a mental health and wellness expo on May 21st of 2022, and it's going to be held right here at Come As You Are. It's going to be from 10 to 1 o'clock, okay? And there's going to be several workshops, and there's going to be over 20-plus vendors. It's going to be health screening, so we'd like to see everybody come out. You can bring your families, but May the 21st from 10 to 1. Some of the workshops are going to be suicide prevention, mental health trauma, so that's just two of the workshops that we're going to be having, but there's 20-plus vendors, okay? And then the last announcement, I want to pray for our partners or talk about our partner for this month. Our partner for today, this Sunday, is the Allen County Cancer Service. And the Allen County Cancer Service of Northeast Indiana is located on Mutual Drive here in Fort Wayne and has been serving this community for over 25 years. And what I love about this service is several of our members have been recipients of this service. Amen. They serve those diagnosed with cancer and their families in the Allen County and 10 other surrounding counties. And I know they had the cancer walk on yesterday. And guess what? Come As You Are made their goal. And so they donated, I think, $500. Give your hands. Yeah, amen. And one more thing. Their mission is to enhance the quality of life of those affected by cancer by providing meaningful resources, information, and compassionate assistance. So, Father, we thank you. We praise you and we give you glory for this service, oh God. We thank you for their dedication and their commitment to this community. Now, Father, we thank you for all those that will contribute and donate to this cancer society. We thank you that there will be no shortage, oh God. And Father, we ask for your special blessings upon them. We thank you, oh God, for the staff. We thank you that there will never, ever be a shortage of staff to serve this community and the surrounding communities. And Father, we thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. We're going to go ahead and get ready for our offering. If you will begin to prepare your hearts and your mind as we get ready to give. We thank God for all that he's giving to us. And we thank God for this community that God has given us to serve in. Amen. And so we want to give today to make sure that the kingdom agenda through Come As You Are Community Church continues to go forth. Amen. If you need an envelope, there is one in the seat in front of you. If you don't see one, please raise your hand. The ushers will come around and make sure you have what you need. All right. If everyone can stand, please. And we're going to follow the directions of the ushers.
Alive and
Jesus Christ, we thank you for every gift, God, and we thank you for every giver. Yes. We ask now, God, that you will press it down, shake it together, and cause it to run over, Lord, that your kingdom agenda will be completed, God, from this place, Lord, and every need be met in every house of every person, God, that followed your direction and gave. We speak blessings over your people, Father God, and let there be no lack, Father God, because they gave unto thee. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Darkness, my God, that is who you are.
miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
You are waymaker.
Waymaker.
Yes, you
miracle
are.
Miracle worker, oh, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Darkness, my God, that is who you are.
You are a waymaker.
Hallelujah. 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 He's a way maker. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's a way maker. Hallelujah. If he's made a way for you, hallelujah. Come on and stand to your feet and give God the glory he deserves. Hallelujah. He's a way maker. He's a promise keeper. He's a light in the darkness. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God.
Waymaker, promise keeper, that's who you are. That's who you are, waymaker, promise keeper. Anybody in here that God has kept a promise to you? I'm a living witness that he will keep his promise. I'm a living witness that he will keep his promise, ladies and gentlemen. Waymaker, promise keeper. I'm a witness, I'm a witness, I'm a witness, I'm a witness. It's Mother's Day. Anybody? Anybody here? Anybody here who know that he'll be a mother that'll rock you at the midnight hour? When there is nobody else there, but he will rock you. Waymaker, promise keeper. That's who he is. Good morning, kayaking, to everyone who's viewing this morning. I want to say happy Mother's Day to everyone who is a mother. And for whatever role you stepped into that mother's role for. Now, we realize that there are some here that may not have mothers and some who may be watching, who desire to be a mother but is not. But for whatever role you have played in a mother, maybe you was a mother and raised your children, and now you're a grandmother and you find yourself with some grandchildren that's calling you mom. Maybe you was a sibling who had to help your mother raise your siblings. And they sometimes didn't always understand that they had to do what you say, even though you was only 5 years older than they are. Or maybe you was an aunt who had to help her sister with two little boys. And she stepped in that role with me. When I saw her walk in this morning, I said, there's a mother. Not only has she played the role of being mother for me, but she's played the role of being mother for my two sons. I'll tell you a little story. One day, she was with us, and my sons was up, and they was wanting something, and we had both come from work, and she'd come in, and they said, Aunt Dot, we want some water. She'd run over here and get the water for Corey. Jarrell would say, Aunt Dot, I want some bread. She'd run over here and get bread. Now, I'm sitting on the couch, y'all. Now, I'm the mama. And they said, Aunt Dot, I want some cookies. She run. So finally she looked at them and she said, don't you see your mama sitting over there? And she looked, they looked at her and they looked at me. And they looked at her and they looked at me. They looked at her and they say, I'm mama tired. So she just looked at them and she never said another word. That conversation never came up again when they wanted her to do something and I was just sitting. Good morning. Good morning and happy Mother's Day. Shall we pray? Father God, in the name of Jesus, we stand boldly before your throne of grace. Father, your word has told us that we can do that, that we can come before your throne of grace boldly. And that's what we are doing today, Lord, in worship of you, for all that you've done for us, all that you're doing for us and all that you will do. We say thank you. Now, Father, I ask more of you and less of me. More of you, Father, and less of me. More of you, Father, and less of me. It is in Jesus' name that I pray and I ask. Amen. Now, happy Mother's Day again to all. Just want to give you a little history about how this Mother's Day started. It's a lady by the name of Anna Jarvis. And she decided that she wanted to honor her mother. Now, I understand that this is a tricky day because we are celebrating mothers and we are celebrating that our mothers are here. And there are some that are celebrating that their mother was here but no longer here. So there are times when we can be really happy and we can just run all over this place and celebrate that we got children. And every time I hear Corey and Jarrell call that name, Mom, it sets my soul on fire. Because, see, I was one of those mothers who was barren for a while. And I prayed and I prayed for 11 years that God would bless me with a child. And finally, in the midst of storms in my life, Corey came along. And every time I hear that boy call and say, Mom, it makes my soul leap. But on the other hand, my mom and my grandmother who raised my older sister and I, when we call that name, there is no answer. When I say Mom, and we called our mom Madea, and we say, Madea, there is no, yeah. And as my grandmother used to say, whoo. There is no response. But in Anna Jarvis, if we think about it, it was after her mom had passed that she wanted to do something to encourage and to recognize and honor her mom. So she decided that she wanted to honor her mom with Mother's Day. And that's what she did. She began to push for that Mother's Day. And she wanted carnations. And if you remember, some of us remember that we used to wear white carnations if your mother had passed, and red if your mother was living. And she pushed for that. But in the end, she was not so happy about what they did because it became more commercialized in selling flowers and cards to make money. Now, we know that anytime man put his hand to it, what happens? Money becomes things. But what I want to talk with us today, ladies and mothers and whatever role you spent in that, and fathers and whoever you may be, because as we celebrate our moms today, I want you to understand that there is sands of time. Your hourglass. And some of you, everybody got our ladies should have an hourglass. And I want you to understand what that means with our mothers and our children's and whatever relationship we have. When you hold up that glass, that hourglass with that sands of time in it, it's running out. And it is not stopping, and it is not waiting for nobody. That sand continues to run. So when you are upset about what your mom didn't do, and you don't remember to say, thank you, Mom. When you're mad and you're slamming doors because she wouldn't let you do something, remember, your hourglass sand is still running. My mom and my grandmother, hourglass sand ran out. But you see, mine, God has given me a little bit more time to understand and to share with you. Don't waste your hourglass time, ladies. Tell your mom how much you love her. Tell your mom you are grateful for what she does. Tell your mom you need a hug from her today. Tell that lady who stepped in that space. Tell her, I love you. I appreciate what God has done for you. Your hourglass, ladies. Look at your hourglass. Hold your hourglass up. My hourglass time is running out, and yours is too. Now for you young mothers. I want you to brag on yourself a little bit. And every mother, I want you to brag on yourself a little bit. I want you to brag about all the things that you did do good. I want you to brag on every tear you caught when that child was crying. I want you to brag on yourself for every bottle you made at night. I want you to brag about every dirty diaper you changed. I want you to brag about today. Brag on yourself a little bit, because motherhood is not easy. It's one of the highest calling that we could ever have, is being a mother. Because you see, God intends for us to teach our children. In our scripture today, it's going to be 2 Thessalonians 3, 3 through 5. And this is what it says, because I want us to understand that we can't do motherhood without God. I don't care how good you are. I don't care how many self-help books you write. I don't care how many times you stand in the mirror and declare, I'm a good mom. Without the help of the Holy Spirit, you can do nothing. Sorry. Thank you. So, 1 Thessalonians, but the Lord is faithful. How many are mothers who know that you needed God to be faithful to you in that time? And he will strengthen and protect you from the evil one. Do you know that there is an enemy you have? Do you know that there is an enemy that you have that's out to get your child? That he's out to snatch every good thing that's in him or her? That he's after to kill? You don't believe me? Check Job. Job prayed for his children because he was so worried that they may have done something and got away with it. But he prayed that God would protect his children. But did the enemy come? He came and took every child Job had. The enemy is out to kill and destroy your children. So I'm telling you, God is our protector. We have confidence in the Lord. How many got confidence in the Lord? If you got confidence, let me see your hands this morning. We have confidence in the Lord that we are doing and will continue to do things we are commanded to do. We are commanded to be moms. We are commanded to catch those tears, wipe those snotty nose. We are commanded to tell our children that God will, he will take care of you. So I am a living witness this morning that God will. But your hourglass is still running. No matter what you do, your hourglass will not stop. So in the midst of all your trouble, in all of your trials, remember, moms, praise yourself, encourage yourself, inspire yourself, and challenge yourself. To be a challenge, we have to have something to challenge for. And I'm telling you, some of you got buckets. Who got buckets? Let me see your buckets. I want you to know, in this challenge, that there is nothing new under the sun. No matter what you're going through, I declare somebody's going through it too. Or somebody has gone through it. They're either in a storm, going through a storm, or coming out of a storm. But I'm telling you, with your storm, you got a bucket. And God has blessed us to have so much in a bucket. And my mom, and this is something that I heard from T.D. Jakes. Like I say, nothing new under the sun. So what you're hearing, you've heard before. But what I want to do is encourage you to use it a little bit more. And T.D. Jakes said, when we look at our moms or our parents, and we are upset about what they did or did not do for us, they may only had a 5-gallon bucket. They may have only had a 5-gallon bucket. So when I think about my mom, my bucket came to mind. Because for years I was upset with my mom about what she didn't do and she should have done. And I was upset. And then when he said that, I thought about my mom had a 5-gallon bucket. And out of that 5-gallon bucket, she had 8 children that she had to try to pour into. And out of that 5-gallon bucket, she had me to deal with who blamed her for everything. She didn't have much education, but she did the best she could. She come out of an abusive marriage, but she was still pouring out of that 5-gallon bucket. She thought, well, I have to let them go with my parents and let mama and papa take care of my children for a little while because I can't right now. So she was pouring out of that 5-gallon bucket. My older sister and my second oldest sister, we was little, and so my grandparents took us, and my mom left and went to Florida, and she worked in the fields of picking tomatoes and cucumbers, and she was pouring out of her 5-gallon bucket. And then she thought, okay, she met this man, and she thought he loved her, and she was going to come and get her children. So she came on, and she got us, and she said, I got my bucket, and I'm going to pour out of my bucket and get my 3 little girls. And she told me one time, she said, I used to always tell my peoples I got 3 little beautiful girls, but I was mean. I was mean to my mom. And still she was pouring out of her bucket. And I say things to my mom like, you didn't love us, and you just let somebody misuse us and mistreat us. And she said, I did the best I could. She was pouring out of her bucket. And I never gave her any credit where she could really understand that I did love her. And then the Lord let me know I gave you a 10-gallon bucket. I gave you a 10-gallon bucket, Joyce Ann. And your mama had a 5-gallon bucket. And out of your 10-gallon bucket, you have spent so much time, your sand time, worrying and arguing and fussing and about what your mom didn't do. So your 10-gallon bucket is not even holding as much as her 5-gallon bucket. So your time is still running out. And I'm still worrying about my mom's 5-gallon bucket and what she didn't do and how come she didn't do, why she didn't leave him, why she left us and she didn't love us out of her 5-gallon bucket. But then I'm telling you, when the Lord let me know, she done did more with her 5-gallon bucket in this time than you did with your 10. So then I tried to get my time back here. I run back, get my hourglass. Because look, ladies, look. Sand time, still moving, still running. And I yet got a little bit, look at it. I yet got a little bit, but it's still running. Okay, now I got to get my 10-gallon bucket. So I went back and I told my mom, I said, my dear, I love you. I appreciate what you did for me. I know you did the best you could. You was the best mom that you could be. And by that time, my sand glass, my mom's memory, Alzheimer had taking control. So she couldn't understand what I was saying to her. And out of my 10-gallon bucket, I was trying to pour into her and say, I love you. And she'd look at me sometime and she would just say, mm-hmm. But my sand time was still running. And my sister began to tell me things about my mom that I didn't know. They said, did you know Madea was a good cook? No, I didn't know that, but they told me that. She said, did you know Madea was a good seamstress? I said, no, I didn't know, but they told me that. She said, did you know that my dear used to love to sing? I knew that because I know she couldn't sing. And but my hourglass was still running and trying to get my 10-gallon bucket to begin to do what the Lord had told me to do. And he said in his word that he would never leave nor forsake me and that he would restore what the cankerworms had stolen. So all my time that I had wasted, my sin time about my mom, and I began to look around and see who else I could pour out of my 10-gallon bucket. So I began to get some young women on my side, and I began to tell them, Jesus love you. I began to tell them, shut your mouth. I began to tell them, you're going to be okay. I began to tell them, Jesus loves you out of my 10-gallon bucket. I'm telling them, look at your bucket. Look at your bucket. And for you young ladies who are not mothers and desiring to be mothers and not wives, but desiring to be wives and women of the Most High God, First, I want you to stand still. And then I want you to step out and know that God is the relationship you need to start out with first. So, in our bucket, 10 gallon. But it got to be filled with Jesus first. Because when our bucket is full with the Almighty, when our bucket is filled with Him, it overflows. It begins to spill out on Miss Twyla. It begins to spill out on Miss Benita. It begins to spill out on Danita. It begins to spill out on Nicole. It begins to spill out on my babies back there who said this morning, Happy Mother's Day, Miss Joyce. Are we going to have class? It begins to spill out on my Corey. It begins to spill out on my Jarrell. It begins to spill out on my Henry Caldwell. Because my 10-gallon bucket that God has given me, I have let go of all those things that my hourglass running every day. Every day. I want you to keep your hourglass and your 10 buckets. And when you get frustrated that this little one may be running around, can't sit down, I want you to take that hourglass and sit him down and say, you see when that sand get down here, you can get up. I want you to take that hourglass and say to that, when that little one who can't seem to understand what you say, I want you to take that hourglass and sit it there and say, see that? Jesus loves you. I want you to turn that hourglass over and look at that child who you sometimes may say, Lord, I didn't ask for this. Or when that child who's grown up and they're teenagers now, and you had them on your heart when they was a baby. Now they're on your lap when they was a baby, but now they're on your heart. When the police call, say something done happened, and you jump out of your bed and run to the jail, and you say, Lord, you know I didn't raise them like that. But you know what the Lord say, train up a child in the way he shall go, and when he's old, he shall not depart. So, your hourglass is running with your children, ladies. It's running. So don't waste your hourglass sand with your 10-gallon bucket being empty because your hourglass is running. And begin to pour out on your people and your children. I tell you, my two sons I tell you about, Corey and Jarrell. I love them two men with all my heart. My two grandsons, Corey and Jarrell. I love them two grandsons. I have a daughter-in-law, Nicole. I love her. I love being a mom. I love this thing called motherhood. I love hugging. Dr. Overton just calls you out when you hug. She said, Miss Caldwell, just hug people and hug them tight. That's because I love, because God reminded me. He gave me a 10-gallon bucket. And what I got in my 10-gallon bucket, I cannot keep. I have to pour my 10-gallon bucket out. And my good friend Piccola wrote this poem, and she said, when I stand before my God, I want to be empty of purpose. Ladies, moms, whatever role you stepped into as a mom, whether it's biological, a grandmother who's raising children, a sister who's helping with her nephew, or you helping with your nieces, or you got cousins, and or you a daughter, and you resent your mom sometime for causing you to have to raise your siblings. And you didn't have a childhood. I want you to know God said, I gave you a 10-gallon bucket. I gave you the grace to be able to raise them siblings. I gave you the grace to love your mom because she was doing the best you could. If you would stop first, seek ye the kingdom of heaven of God and all these things will be added unto you, your 10-gallon bucket. Now, some of you got a 20-gallon bucket. Some of you may have a 30-gallon bucket. But I declare those people who had those 5-gallon buckets, they made the difference. They raised doctors and lawyers. They was slaves. And they raised congressmen. They raised inventors. They raised you and I. Because we stand on their shoulders. With my 10-gallon bucket, I understand that my hourglass is running low. I don't have as many days ahead of me as I got behind me. But I declare, as my grandmother used to say, if God said it, I declare it would happen. And he said that my latter days will be better than my former. So be encouraged, moms. Even when you are frustrated with your child, even when you wondered, why did I ever have this child? Brag on yourself a little bit that I did that thing. Moms, let me hear you say, I did that thing. I did that thing. I did that thing. I did that thing for Corey and Jarrell. My sister used to say, I was a bad mom. I said, not me. I may have made some mistakes. I may have said some wrong words. But I did that thing. I did that thing. Them young men, my son preach in the pulpit. My young son, he ain't preaching, but he preach in the barbershop. When he go get his hair cut, he's always talking about it. I did that thing. With the help of the Holy Spirit, with the help of my sister, my family, my friends, this is a village. It is a village. And we can't do it alone. And that's why God put us in a body. And we got to come along and embrace our children, love them, and let them know that God loves you. And the last piece of information I want to give you before I close and sit down. God don't have no grandchildren. Did you know that? Did you know that? Did you know God don't have any grandchildren? How many of you knew that? Oh, a few of us knew that. God don't have grandchildren. So in our children and raising our children, sometimes our children have a right to be upset because of what happened to us. I don't take away from what happened to my sisters and I. And I'm telling you, it was horrific. It was horrific. But God said that he would heal the brokenhearted. And I think for me, it took what I went through for me to get to where I am. And so, moms, understand that it's okay to say to your child or your grandchild, but most of all, God's child, when you made a mistake, and even if they're grown now and you know that what you did or what you said was wrong. My grandmother used to say when she'd whoop us, some people got spankings. I was not one of them who got spankings. We got whoopings. There's a difference. There's a vast difference in a spanking and a whooping. And when they whoop you, they talk the whole time. And then you cry. Don't you cry. You shut up. And then mama would find out she whooped me for nothing when she could catch me because I was a runner. She found out she whooped me for nothing. And instead of her coming and say, I am sorry, that was wrong. She said, I just missed you for something else you should have got a whooping for. Won't they do it? Now y'all stop doing that stuff. Go to your child and say, the Holy Spirit let me know that I was wrong, what I did to you. And I apologize to you for what I did or for what I said. And that's going to let that child know that God is concerned about them because he got you on account of them. Hallelujah. Now, I want you to stop doing that and begin to tell your child about the great I am. At the table, when you sit down to eat, turn off the radios, the cell phone, and tell them about the goodness of God. The food that they're about to receive is because of his provision. Talk about them when you walk down the road. When you put them to bed at night, tell your children about the Lord. And mothers, when we stand before God on that great day, as some of our mamas are done that, they are with the Almighty God. But they poured out of them buckets they had. They poured everything they had out of that bucket in us. And they left a legacy for us to do the same for our children. And so when they're standing before God, and they're going to come a time when we all be there, and they can look over at you and say, I did that thing. And when we stand before God, my greatest, greatest, greatest desire is when I stand before God, I be empty of purpose. To God be the glory. Thank you.
Anticipated tonight, your anointing.
Your anointing.
Your spirit, Jesus.
Your divine.
In this place.
In this
hallelujah.
Your power.
Is there anyone that needs the Holy Ghost to fall in the room tonight?
Your heal.
Come on, let's take it. Your mercy, Jesus.
Your mercy.
We invite you in. So come on, lift your hands to heaven right now and tell him,
come to this place.
Of the Lord, rest in our midst.
That was a powerful message. Miss Joyce, I thank God for your bucket. Because without you pouring, I wouldn't be standing here. And I know I'm not the only one. Because I see the fruit in this place. So I bless God for you. Thank you for letting God use you. Those of you out there watching and even in the room, I believe God spoke a word of deliverance today. And he wants to heal hearts. I don't know about you, because I don't know your relationship with your mother, but I haven't always honored mine. And I have to repent because my mom has been good to me. And I thank God for my mom. Sometimes we take for granted the gifts that God has given us because we're looking at what we don't have. Instead of allowing God to show us what he has given us and what we do have. So if you have a mother and you find yourself where I am, open your hearts and ask God to forgive you so that that relationship can be mended and so that you can be released from that weight because you don't have to carry it. And to the children, we know that we have not always done right by you. And sometimes we only did what we knew to do. But we love you. We love you. And we thank God for you. So if you're carrying the weight of guilt, give it to Jesus this morning. And thank God, if you still have time in your hourglass, thank God for the time that you still have. And be purposeful and intentional about using it to honor your mothers. And mothers, be intentional about honoring your children. Let's go before the Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, you see every mother, you see every child, you see every heart that has been broken, Father God, by the circumstances of life in which we've had to grow up. But Father, we come knowing, first of all, that you didn't make a mistake and you put us where you placed us in those families for a purpose. So, Father God, we come asking, God, that you would first forgive us, Lord. Forgive us for complaining. Forgive us, Lord God, for being spiteful to our parents or our children. Forgive us, Lord God, for neglecting to love, God, where you have given us the opportunity to love. Forgive us for being harsh, God, when we should have shown love and mercy and grace, God, just as you have shown us, Father God. We ask in the name of Jesus Christ, God, that you will release and break the yokes of bondage today, God. We ask right now in the name of Jesus that as you're breaking yokes, God, as you're healing hearts, Lord God, that you would begin to mend the relationships, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that you would grant us wisdom, Lord. And Father God, teach us what your word tells us. Teach us how to number our days. Teach us, God, to be mindful that tomorrow is not promised to us, and then help us to live accordingly. We thank you and we give you honor in Jesus' name. We bless God. We bless God. Listen, listen, listen. It all starts. She said it all starts with filling your bucket with Jesus. So if you don't know Jesus in the pardon of your sins, it's not too late. And I'm here to tell you that you haven't gone too far and you have not done too much. The blood of Jesus still has power, and he wants you saved. The Bible says in Ephesians 1 that he has already ordained and chosen and predestined you for salvation. He wants you to be his child. So we ask that if you're watching us, please call 260-447-6036 so we can get you in touch with somebody that can walk you through the plan of salvation. And if you're in the house, don't leave this place without Jesus. Ministers, please raise your hand. Those of you that work with Partners of Purpose, please raise your hands. We want you to be saved. So if you see these hands and you know that you want Jesus and you want to be saved, that you want to give your life over, find one of us today. Don't leave this place. We want you to be saved and have all and be all that God has intended for you to be. All right, amen. Listen, we're going to get out of here. So if you all will please stand. Thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. We bless God for you. And take the word with you throughout this week. And know that God is with you. And he loves you. And he cares about you. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you for all that we have experienced. We thank you, Lord, for the power of your word, Lord. And we thank you for the vessel that you use today, God. We thank you and we ask you, Lord God, that you allow that word to take root in our hearts. Father God, that you would help us to live out this word. Father, your word says that you want us to be doers and not just hearers of your word. So let us put your word to work this week, Lord God. Father, we ask a blessing on your people, Father God, that you will bless, keep them. Father God, everywhere that they go, let them know that they are with you, God, that you have not left them alone, that no matter what they face throughout this week, that you are indeed fighting for them. We bless your